Melodically, this is the best booty song so far. She got the boom, shake the room. This is poetry, guys. The lyrics have been amazing in this video. Welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joe from Rumi Official, and you are looking bold and fearless. Keep going, girl. Today, I got a very special video for you guys. We're gonna be looking at songs about booty. And we're gonna be crowning the best one. For privacy reasons, I've turned my eye tracker off. Let's do this. First off, we have Doja Cat's Juicy, released in 2019, and it peaked at number 41 on the Billboard Hot 100. She commented on the song's subject in a Genius interview.
I like butts, and I think about butts, and I felt like making a butt song, because I made a booty song, so I was like, all right, let me just make a butt song.
I mean, that's as good a reason as any, I guess. I don't know. You could see it from the phone, but tell you see it from the cat, yeah. This is always nightmare inducing. I don't know, this half right here always messes with me. Like to keep on wanting more. He asked me, told you where you at, huh? Okay, so musically, I don't really care too much about it. It's not really a vibe, and it's not very clever either. It doesn't have a lot. I do like that melody. So the theme is bananas, cherries, and watermelons. None of those things make me think booty necessarily. So fruit salad song. Peaches does mean booty. On the track, she expresses confidence and body positivity. The thing is, this is not controversial. Like, booty has been around for a while and been celebrated for a while now. She's not really saying anything that everyone else isn't saying. I guess it's brave. I keep it juicy, juicy. I eat that lunch. She keep that booty, booty. She keep that plump. That natural beauty, beauty. Yeah, yeah. If you could see it from the front, wait till you see it from the back. It's meaning the body, right? Back, 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 back. Ah, this line is a little bit funny. Okay, he on his knees attend the mass. You know what I mean? Like, mass. Mass as in church, but also mass as in... Overall, this isn't very clever or very amazing to me. The chorus is catchy, but that's about it. Juicy gets a 5 out of 10. Next booty song, please. Give me more booty. Here we got Kanye West's Mercy from 2012. Picked on number 13 on the Hot 100. Lamborghini Mercy. Yo chick, she so thirsty. I'm in that 2C Lambo with your girl. She trying to jerk me. Okay. Drop it to the flow. Make that a shake. Whoa. Make the ground move. That's an quake. Quake. I love how these songs always try to be clever and then you're like, That's an state. Roll my weed on it. That's an straight. So dumb. What was I expecting though? Making a video about booty songs. Am I expecting high pros here? Okay, drop it to the floor. Make that shake. Whoa, make the ground move. That's an quake. Oh my god. Built a house up on that. That's an state. This is just puns and they're not good. What a dad rap. I mean, I can't say anything. Roll, roll, roll my weed on it. That's an trade.
I'm hurting.
That verse gets a 3 out of 10. I think if the song would have felt more playful, he might have been able to get away with those dad jokes with such a serious beat and everything. It doesn't make any sense. Destiny's Child, Bootylicious, released in 2001 and peaked on number 1 on the Hot 100. So this is a bit of a special booty song. It popularized the term bootylicious and created moderate controversy in a time when late music was pushing the boundaries of female sexuality. So I guess kind of their version of what WAP is doing right now. Like WAP is even more explicit, probably. Why is all this about female booties? Where are the songs about male booties? This is sexism. Okay, maybe not. I take that back. Don't hurt me. How was this ever controversial? I guess that's the thing about controversial songs. If they really have an impact, then what was controversial with it will get really just normal. I guess there was a time when people didn't even sing about anything naughty or about bodies at all. They were all like, hey, would you like to look at my car? And everyone would be like, oh no! He said look at the car? We know what happens in the car at the drive-in theater. This is too edgy. Melodically, this is the best booty song so far, I would say. You gotta do much better if you're gonna dance with me tonight. You gotta work your jelly. If you're gonna dance with me tonight. Okay, so it is about the guy needs to work his... I'm not gonna do any cringy dancing in this video. I don't think you're ready for this jelly. That's right, I am not ready for your jelly. In the 1800s, jelly roll was used by African Americans to mean female parts.
Really?
So it's not like a full-on booty song like the other ones we've heard. I feel like it's more like, ooh, I am hot. Although Beyoncé claimed that she created the word bootylicious, it was actually coined by Snoop Dogg in 1992 on Dr. Dre's track with Dre Day. As far as booty songs go so far, I feel like it's the gold standard. 8 out of 10 for bootylicious. By the way, if you want something to wear above your booty, please consider buying our merch. It's on November sale right now. I'm saving up to buy the band Rednecks. Please support. It's so cheap. Thank you. Let's get some more booty, shall we? Here we got Big Sean's Dance, parentheses, A word. It was released in 2011 and it peaked on number 10 on the Billboard Hot 100. Now make that motherfucker hammer sound like. This is one of those songs where, like, you can totally see why it's used and why it became big, but it's hard to say the level of musicality, the level of the song isn't high. Anyone at a random college could have come up with this song. It's genius in its simplicity. Stacking my paper, my wallet look like a Bible. I got girlies half naked, that look like the grotto. High your waist anorexic and then your is colossal. Like, whoop, drop that ass, make it boomerang. Tile tippy tay, you gon' get a tip today. We gotta censor all of it. The wobbledy wobbledy wah. There's good lines in here. I'm stacking my paper, my wallet look like a Bible. In its simplicity, it's still good. Dance parentheses A word gets a 6 out of 10 on the booty list. Ooh, outlier. Here we got Casey and the Sunshine Band, Shake Your Booty, released in 1976 and peaked on number 1 on the Hot 100.
Bruh.
Shake, 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 shake your booty holds the record for being the only number 1 song title with a word repeated more than 3 times in it. That's a very specific charts record. So ahead of its time with the booty music. This is so lame though, just because things like this progress. This might have been edgy at the time, but now I feel like the only people who would dance to this, like really excitedly, would be toddlers, right? It would be like, aha, I'm 2 years old. Feels like a diaper song. You would dance to this in your diaper. These lyrics are like the first thing you would think of and then you don't change it. Ah, everybody, get on the floor, let's dance. Don't fight your feelings, give yourself a chance. Shake, 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 shake your booty. There's literally nothing to this song. That's all lyrics there are. Now, musically, it's kind of fun in a way. So, gets a 6 out of 10, Shake Your Booty. Here we have Jennifer Lopez, Booty, featuring Iggy Azalea. Released in 2014, it peaked at number 18 on the Billboard Hot 100. Interestingly, this song was first rejected by Jennifer Lopez. However, after playing the demo for her kids and seeing that they enjoyed the track, Lopez was convinced to record it. After her kids liked the booty song, she was like, yeah, I'm gonna record this for the kids. It was initially recorded and released with Pitbull. However, for the single release, Azalea's verses replaced those of Pitbull, whose verses were about Lopez's buttocks-related skills. Azalea instead talks about her own buttocks-related skills. What is this video? What's happening? I love it. This is great. At least there's no confusion in the music video what the lyrics are about. I feel like they work in harmony. Booty and the booty. Have you seen her on the dance floor? She got the boom, shake the room. That's the lightning and the thunder. She got the boom in the room, guys. See the light in her eyes and it starts to make you wonder. There have been like 2 shots of faces so far in the music video. That's all I'm gonna say about that. I kinda like that chorus. It's pretty groovy, the drum beat and everything. It's music for a specific reason, obviously, and for a specific way of selling music, but that drum beat slaps. Okay, all the freaky girls at the party, grab a man and bring him to the dance floor. Okay, so that's fine for the freaky girls. How about the cute girls, huh? How about the average looking girls? What are they gonna do? Come on. Quick look at the lyrics here as well. The lyrics have been amazing in this video so far. I love it. Have you seen her on the dance floor? She got the boom, shake the room. Great. Poetry. That's the lightning and the thunder. You want to meet her. You want to touch her. See the light in her eyes and it starts to make you wonder. And then we just kind of like switch totally. It was kind of like singing to, I guess, a guy. And now it's all the freaky girls in the party. Grab a man. Bring him to the dance floor. Go on. Let them jeans touch you while you're dancing. Is it the guy's jeans? Are we talking like a lap situation? Okay. This is poetry, guys. Okay. This one should really be a 3 out of 10, but I like the drum beat in the chorus. It's groovy and kind of some of the K-pop stuff is pretty cool. So get an extra point for that. I also want to point out that these are called like Booty, Juicy, Mercy, and Dance. It's almost like the people are really into this type of music also aren't great at writing or reading words. Here we got Eminem's A Word Like That. Eminem, I feel, could probably do some pretty clever wordplay. It was released in 2005 and hits number 60 on the Billboard Hot 100. I don't get what this information here means, but it says Eminem raps his ode to the booty like Triumph, the insult comic dog. What? When she moves, she's like a ballet dancer. She's shaking
that to the new jams. I think someone's at the door, but I don't think I'm an answer. Police saying freeze. Doing, doing, doing. What do you mean, freeze? Please, I'm a human being. I have needs. I'm not done. Not till I'm finished being. I am not resisting arrest. I am agreeing, Mr. Officer. I'm already on my knees.
This is kind of what I expected. This old Eminem stuff is so bizarre. It's so funny and like edgy. Some of its references and like wordplay is in a way where like I'm not sure if I'm allowed to laugh at this.
The way you shake it, I can't believe it. I ain't never seen a like that.
All the girls are taller than him. How tall is Eminem? Is he short? Yeah, he's about my height. He is kind of short to medium.
You make my slinky go. Doing, doing, doing.
You make my slinky go doing, doing, doing. He censored himself for me. Thanks, man. In what many consider to be the low point in Eminem's career, the hit singer from 2004's Encore features an India-flavored beat while Eminem impersonates Triumph, the comic insult dog, who had insulted Eminem in the past, getting arrested in various situations for freak crimes. Every day, I had a pocket full of pills, and I would just go into the studio and goof off. That's so funny that it's considered like his worst work. I guess it is. I'm not resisting arrest. I am agreeing. Mr. Officer, I'm already on my knees. I can't get on the ground any further. It's impossible for me. Is that a pee-pee size joke? And do not treat me like a murderer. I just like to pee. Pee-pee, yes. I make R&B. I sing song. I go ring-a-chong. A ching-chong. If I offend, I'm sorry. Please, please forgive. Wow, okay. This is not clever necessarily. It's got that funny Eminem vibe. It's hard to hate on it. It's hard to say that it's good necessarily. Gonna have to give it a 6 out of 10. For our next booty song, we have Meghan Trainor's All About That Bae, which was released in 2014 and hit number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100. So Meghan Trainor intended the song to promote positive body image and self-acceptance. The song was noted for discussing booty as part of physical attractiveness. Was this the starting point of people putting silicone in their booties?
I ain't no size 2, but I can shake it like I'm supposed to do. Cause I got that boom boom that all the boys chase. All the right junk.
Is this like hating on skinny people a little bit? That shot seems weird. They casted like a bladder actress, whatever, and she's there like, you got booty out. I remember people thinking that this song was so likable when it came out, but these shots are not amazing. At least not now. It's not the worst thing in the world to make fun of people that have a certain body type or whatever, but doing it under the guise of body positivity is a little bit weird too, right?
If you got beauty, beauty, just raise them up, cause every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top.
Every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top, unless you are skinny, as we can see in this music video. Man, I'm really going off of this for some reason. Whoa, what's happening?
Cause you know I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble.
It's a catchy song for sure. I mean, the lyrics are what they are. But yeah, it is interesting that people always struggle when they're trying to do empowerment stuff to not hit on like whatever is the opposite of what it is. Like, can't we just all be like, things are great. This is great, then this is great. Instead, it's always like comparing all the time. Fun fact, Beyonce was presented this song to record and she considered it for a while. Huh. I think this song is all right. I don't think it's aged super well. I remember thinking it was catchy at the time, but I'm gonna go ahead and give it a 6 out of 10. Okay, guys, click here for more music reacts and reviews. Click here for music VS videos. And the winning booty song in this booty shakedown is this booty song. Congratulations, booty song. And let me know if you would like us to do another booty video. We collected a lot more booty songs that we couldn't fit into this video. So let me know in the comments down below. And I will see you tomorrow in another daily video.
Keep that booty juicy, or don't.
A lot of you are minors. Don't listen to me. Bye.